Legend tells that in the far north, about every 100 years, winter is so severe in the high mountains that no living thing can survive. During this coldest of winters, the wildest animals, among them the Siberian tiger, come down from the mountains in search of food and to escape the bitter cold. These huge predators follow the caribou herds and make their way southward in two directions, to Manchuria and India and toward Alaska. These extreme winters begin, according to the legend, when the north wind blows.
I wonder what he's thinking.
Mountains, forests.
You said that as if you knew all about him.
We come from the same place.
Siberia?
It was the coldest winter in 50 years. Everything living seemed to disappear from the land. We hadn't seen tigers for a long time. But that winter, they came down from the mountains, starving creatures. It was a small village where we lived. And once or twice a year, my friend Ava the Trapper would come down from the mountains to sell his pelts at the store. He was a quiet man, a gentle man of the wilderness.
Oh, I thought you'd perished for sure this time.
It is good to see you, Boris.
Look at you. Still strong like a bear.
What is this? How long have you had this condition?
I like it. It makes life seem a little more gentle.
And it hides the truth.
Come by the fire.
Make yourself warm. I want to hear everything.
How long have I had this condition? How was it this time?
Not very good.
This is all?
It's a bad year.
It was a bad year last year. And the year before.
It will get better.
Ava, it's finished. This way of life is finished.
We are both finished, Boris. Only you choose to wait it out here. I choose to fight it out there.
It doesn't have to be a fight.
But I like...
Life can be pleasant.
I like to fight. It reminds me that I'm alive.
You're still as stubborn as ever. Ivan's back. He's grown like a man.
How is that spoiled puppy?
He never stops to think or listen.
I never knew a youngster who did.
He raced off to the Semyonich's farm today just because the old man came to town shouting about tigers.
I saw their tracks in the snow.
There haven't been tigers in these parts for years. Probably just a big lynx.
But they were tigers. Down from the mountains.
You're serious? Well, the boy's no match for tigers.
If he's carrying a rifle, he'll never see one. They're the shadows of the forest.
Time for dinner, son.
How goes it, Ivan?
Good. How's the trapper?
Surviving.
That big lynx of yours just killed Semyonich's horse.
You were right. It was a tiger. Ava saw his tracks.
It was two tigers. I saw them tonight in the forest. They're bigger than horses.
You were lucky they didn't bother you.
I wish they had. I would have shot them tonight instead of tomorrow. You find that amusing?
Never hunted a tiger.
All it takes is just one little bullet.
Those young fools won't even wait for some experienced help. They think a tiger hunt is a picnic.
You want me to go with them?
Would you?
You think they'd let me?
No. But go anyway. I'll make it worth your while.
I don't go for the money. I go to see the tigers. They're like you and me. Almost history.
Ava, you'll stay close to the boy?
Don't worry. He won't even see a tiger today.
Difficult thing, this hunting tigers.
We'll get them tomorrow.
You would do better to leave the dogs behind. They make too much noise.
You don't like the way we're hunting. Why don't you leave?
It does not matter to me how you do it. Time means nothing to me. A day, even a week.
Kill a tiger at this range. If you wound him, he will kill you.
Touch me again and I'll kill you.
sorry. I tried to warn you.
What happened? It's Ivan Binovsky. He's been shot. Get the doctor.
Miyoka, get your things and go to Buinovsky's. There's been an accident.
You're going to be all right, my son.
Ava. Where's Ava?
We must elevate him. Give me some pillows. Quickly.
If it was an accident, why do you think they were fighting before it happened?
They were fighting?
Yes. They're at each other like tigers.
Did you see them, Alex?
They were fighting.
That's still no proof. The shooting could still have been an accident.
How is he?
You should never have gone on the hunt.
There was nothing wrong with the hunt. He's getting ready to leave.
See, what did I tell you? Would an innocent man leave her at this time?
He's going nowhere until we see what happens to Ivan.
Come on, Alex.
Better stay here until we see what happens to Ivan.
He's in good hands. There's nothing I can do by staying.
What if he died?
But you killed him.
It was an accident.
And you have nothing to fear by staying.
Get away from the dog. Put it down. I have said it was an accident.
It is only your word.
Then you must believe it. Hike!
If he dies, we will be coming for you!
Thank you.
What is going on here?
It's the old man. He's getting away.
What do you mean he's getting away?
He has escaped.
He had nothing to escape from. What are you saying? It was an accident. Ivan said it was an accident. Where is he?
He left towards the hills.
You ran him out of the village? Move over! Hurry up!
On the tracks.
He probably jumped off the sled miles back.
Then we must turn back.
It's too late. There's nothing we can do now. He believes he is a hunted man.
We could find his tracks in the morning.
They'd be covered by the winds. He could disappear out here forever.
Petrushka.
Always cheerful, huh? I like that. You're hungry, huh? We'll get something in the morning. I'm glad you're here.
What are you thinking? Are you angry because I killed your mate? Or are you like the forest? Cold, unfeeling.
Anything?
Nothing.
Do you think anyone could survive out here alone?
He's here. The dog knew it. If only we'd been quick enough to follow him.
How he can survive is unbelievable to me.
Well, everything that we fear, he enjoys. He's part of all this. When you're part of something, it becomes your friend.
What do you think he is doing now?
Probably sitting comfortably in an old trapper's hut. Waiting.
Waiting? For what?
For the inevitable end.
You think he's giving up?
No. No, he will never give up. He enjoys the fight too much.
Then what do you think he will do?
Yeah, he will do what we are all doing. He will try to survive.
Thank you.
Tushka. Tushka.
He tried working in the mills at Radvig one year, but he couldn't stand that.
Why? What was the problem?
Well, the work was boring. Papa had youngsters half his age he didn't respect, pushing him around. That's nice. When he was a boy, a man was judged by his strength, not by how many books he'd read. So, one day he put two of the supervisors in the hospital and went back to trapping.
He couldn't still make a living at that, could he?
He knew it was finished, but what does a man do when his world ceases to exist?
Do you think he's still alive?
2 months is a long time. Even the tigers couldn't survive this winter out there.
Thank you. This must be the old man's place.
Can you see him?
Yeah. No, he's coming for you.
Boris Fionovsky.
Yes, that's me.
I'm Cesar Malik. I've come from Kalvaros to hunt the tiger.
Oh, my friend, Peter Chacon.
Welcome.
Glad to meet you.
You came a long way just to kill a tiger.
Oh, we did not come to kill her. We came to take her alive for the zoo.
Then you have a difficult profession.
Well, that's what we do.
You think you can catch a mouse?
Well, by the looks of things, I'm sure I could do better than you.
You must be cold. Would you like some hot soup? I just made it.
Thank you. Oh, it smells good.
There we are. Sit down, sit down.
Oh, thank you. Ah, just a moment. I have men and equipment outside.
This is the place. You go to Sinkers. I'll join you there.
You heard the man.
Go down to Sinkers. I bet the store owner has a beautiful daughter.
There are no beautiful women in these parts.
How do you know that?
I have been looking for 40 years.
It was the first one I had seen in my whole life.
There used to be tigers all over these mountains. From the Ussuri down to Pakal. But now if we find one a year, we are lucky.
Well, it's been 2 months since the hunt. The tigress could be anywhere by now.
If she is out there, we'll find her.
You be careful out there, Peter.
Don't you worry about it. We'll take good care of him. It's good to have someone along who knows his way.
Well, he has an ulterior motive.
You mean the old man? If we see him, we'll bring him back.
I hope so.
I remember I was hunting an old wolf a few years ago. I think we would have caught him easy on the flatlands, but he was much too clever. Higher and higher he climbed into the mountains, where the air gets thin and the man tires quickly.
There's something almost human about the way a wolf thinks. He knows a man's limitations, and hunting one is almost like competing with another man. In all my life, I'd never shot an animal except in self-defense. My reward is to see the wonder in children's faces at the zoo. In time, the zoos will build larger confines for these wild animals, just like their former homes. That's the work of tomorrow. As the day wore on, I found myself at the very tops of the mountains. I had never been in such a silent, lonely place. Even the wind sounded strange and foreboding. I began to feel uneasy, as if something were watching me. At first, I thought it was the wolf, but it wasn't. It was a white tiger, one of the rarest creatures in the world. As a boy, I'd heard tales about these animals and about the men who had tried to hunt them and never returned. I'd never seen such a beautiful creature. And in a strange way, I felt myself lured towards her. It was impossible for the tiger to have doubled back on me. And yet there she was, behind. All of a sudden, I felt that I was no longer the hunter, but the hunted. It was almost magical the way the tiger moved from rock to rock without me seeing her. As I continued onward, I began to think of the men who had hunted the tiger and never returned. In the distance, I suddenly heard the dogs barking. And then silence. I knew the wolfhounds were no match for the tiger. You need smaller, faster dogs to hunt a big cat. As I cleared the ridgetop, the tiger had disappeared. Only one of the dogs were left alive. As I went to his side, I knew the tiger was watching me, hidden in the rocks close by. For a moment, I hated her for what she had done. And then I realized that we were the trespassers. She was simply defending her last refuge from mankind. This was the tiger's way of saying the mountains belonged to her and to no one else.
That's it. Come on. Stay always behind me. If you overrun the tiger, she will kill you.
What we do with Yermak Sheriff, he can't keep up.
Don't worry. If she's a runner, I'll be there.
What if she's a fighter?
I hope we all be there.
I don't like these trees. We go around.
Seems fine.
What happened?
A tiger jumped him. It saved my life.
This old man saved your life?
Ah.
It was as if he were defending the tiger. He shot one of the hunters in the leg and disappeared into the forest. They were so mad. They would have shot him if they had seen him.
Yeah, we must go after him.
We tried to follow him, but he just disappeared.
The hunters will return. God knows what will happen then.
It will be months before they are ready for that.
Did you get a good look at him?
Just for a moment. He looked wild, like an animal.
call you Tarek. You, my little friend, will be Lika.
Hello, baby.
Watch those claws.
Oh!
Did you get him?
I think so.
shoot.
Come on. Let's get out of here.
They have seen him again. He's still alive.
They have seen who?
Ava. Two hunters were out in the forest near Krasnov. They shot at a tiger and were then attacked by a man with a bow and arrow.
That's Ava. Was anybody hurt?
One of the hunters was shot in the arm, nothing serious, but they told me they shot back at the man.
And?
He fell, and they are not sure if he was hit or not.
We go to look for him first thing in the morning. Do they remember where it happened?
Yeah, they are organizing a hunt from Krasnov in the morning.
I pray to God we find him now.
Like a fresh grave.
Shall we see what's in it?
Here, I'll hold the horses.
It's a tiger.
Shall we dig it up?
No. We must keep after the old man. He could still be wounded.
Not very badly if he dug that hole.
He crossed over.
That's a long swim. Do you think he could make it?
The way he's been getting around, yeah.
Well, let's cross over and keep after him.
You'd be wasting your time. That's solid timber. Cannot follow on horse.
We'll go on foot then.
Not with my hounds.
Maybe he floated downriver.
Freeze to death if he stayed in there long.
Well, we can't just give up like this. The man's desperate. He could die out here.
He survived 6 months.
That doesn't mean he could go on forever.
Well, when he's that desperate, maybe he'll come out on his own.
as I ask and leave me?
Let me follow behind. He will never see me.
No. I must do this on my own. He will never come out if there's someone else here. If I am not back in 2 days, you can come looking for me.
But you are not prepared to stay out here. You have no supplies, nothing.
I have got more than I need.
All right. You have 2 days. Good luck.
Ava! Ava, come!
Bigger. Derek, come.
Ava? Ava!
Don't worry, nothing is wrong. I only want to talk to you.
What is it you want with me?
Ava! Thank God I found you. It's all right, Ava. Ivan told me the shooting was an accident. I've been trying to tell you that ever since. You must come back with me.
Why?
Because this is no way to live. You can't spend the rest of your life in this wilderness. The snows will begin again soon.
I should grow old and useless in a place where people think age is an illness.
You could live with me. We can work together in the store.
Boris, leave me alone. Go back to your world. Leave me in mine.
I cannot do that. It is not right that you live here alone anymore.
Why is it not right?
It's unnatural. Uncivilized.
It is the most natural thing in the world. It is your way that is uncivilized.
Lika, come here!
Oh. Hey, Lika.
Easy now. the last I ever saw of Baba. We were the closest of friends. And yet we were from different worlds and could no longer communicate. That year, the snows came early. And as winter fell upon the land, I wondered how a man could survive in such a wilderness.
Come on, Pablo, you all right? Get on, let's go. Yeah. It is long time since we caught two in one day, huh?
Palma, I've never seen you move so fast.
Even your Mac moved fast today.
They are young cats. It was an easy hunt.
There's nothing wrong with things being easy.
He's getting soft already.
Let's get him loaded before he's strong enough to fight again.
Do you think the old man is still living out here?
The old man could not survive alone. He's probably moved on to some settlement.
I wonder how many tigers are left in these parts.
I wonder how many are left in the whole world.
He's a beautiful creature.
Derek! Lika!
I'm stressed. I'll say a prayer. Woo!
That was the last we ever heard of Ava in our district. But every now and again, a traveler in the high country returns with tales of a man living with two tigers. Ava Kum had learned to survive with the knowledge of man and the strength of tigers. He determined to go far away where the north wind blows and the white tiger lives. Such a man cannot be defeated. He fights until he has a place or position where he will win.